Dear students, welcome you all to EPG Pathsala. I am Dr. S. Gandhimadi, Associate Professor, Department of Economics, Avinash Lingam Institute for Home Science and Higher Education for Women, Coimbatore. In this module, we are going to discuss about analysis of variance. Introduction. Analysis of variance is one kind of statistical technique which helps to test the homogeneity or uniformity by comparing different groups. Generally, total variance is divided into two components, that is, total variance equal to variance between samples plus variance within samples. Thus, the sum of two variance is, however, the total variance. The purpose of considering variance of these two types is to find out the influence of different forces working on them. The difference between group sample means are due to the influence of the matter experimented as well as the sampling variation between the samples. Application of analysis of variance. Today, the analysis of variance technique is being applied in nearly every type of experimental design in natural sciences as well as social sciences. This technique is predominantly applied in following fields. That first one, testing the significance of difference between several means. Like student t-test, it is not limited to two samples means of small samples. It is applied to test the significance of the difference of means of more than two samples. This helps in concluding that the different samples have been drawn from the same universe. Then second one, testing the significance of difference in variations. The analysis of variance is also applied to test the significance of difference in variance. Then third one, testing the homogeneity in two-way classifications. When the samples are divided in several categories on the basis of two attributes, even then this technique is helpful in testing the significance of homogeneity. The next one, testing the correlation ratio and regression. The analysis of variance provides exact test of significance for the correlation ratio, departure from linearity of regression and the multiple correlation coefficient. In this way, analysis of variance is an important and useful technique of research work in various fields of knowledge. Then let us discuss assumption underlying analysis of variance. The analysis of variance technique is based upon the following fundamental assumptions. First one is normality. Each of the samples is drawn from a normal population. However, when the sample sizes are large, the assumption of normality is automatically fulfilled. Then second assumption is homogeneity of variance, that is, sample variance should be equal to, that is, sigma 1 squared equal to sigma 2 squared equal to sigma n squared. Then third assumption is additive property. The total variance should be equal to the total of variances of different classes. In other words, the variances due to different sources should be additive to total variances. The next assumption is independence. The selection of samples should be random, independent, and equally likely. In case of samples not being independent, problem of multicollinearity arises, which affects the inference of analysis of variance. It should be kept in mind that whenever any of these assumptions are not fulfilled, the analysis of variance technique cannot be applied to give valid result. This is confirmed by many economic and business experiments, but in the situations where these assumptions are not fully met, the transformed data may be used for analysis of variance. In practice, the researchers find no significant loss in the adequacy of t-test if one or more of these assumptions are bent, provided the data are reasonably close to meeting the assumptions. If the underlying distributions are bimodal or highly skewed, the f-test inferences will not be valid. Remarkably, greater the variance around the sample means, the samples must be widely dispersed around the grand mean, very likely not representing random the same population. However, when the sample means are very narrowly dispersed around their sample means, the samples are likely to be random samples from a common population. Then let us discuss what are the techniques of analysis of variance. The various methods of analysis of variance can be studied under the following classification. The analysis of variance can be studied as one-way classification or two-way classification, and it can be studied by using direct method, shortcut method and coding method. Then one-way classification. Under one-way classification, influence of any one factor is considered. In other words, the data are classified according to only one criteria. The direct method. The following steps will be helpful in reaching to a valid inference from the analysis of variance. The first step is null hypothesis. We may set up the null hypothesis like H0 colon mu 1 equal to mu 2 equal to mu k. That is, the arithmetic means of population from which the samples are randomly drawn are equal to one another. Alternative hypothesis. The alternative hypothesis in this case can be set up as H1 colon mu 1 not equal to mu 2 not equal to mu k. That is, means of the population from which k samples were randomly drawn are not equal to each other. Then test statistics. Under H0, we can take test statistics F equal to variance between the samples divided by variance within the samples. That is equal to greater variance divided by smaller variance. That is equal to S1 square divided by S2 square, where S1 square is equal to variance between the sample means and S2 square is equal to variance within the sample means. Let us discuss computations of variance between the samples. The variance between samples shows the difference between the sample mean of each group and the overall mean weighted by the number of observations in each group. It takes into account the random observations from observation to observation. It also measures the difference from one group to another. For calculating the variance between the samples, we take the total of the square of the deviations of the means of various samples from the grand mean and divide this total by degrees of freedom. The calculation of the variance between the samples may be performed as follows. Calculate the mean of each sample, that is x1 bar, x2 bar, x3 bar and x4 bar, etc. Compute the grand mean based on all items irrespective of column grouping. It is obtained as grand mean is equal to x1 bar plus x2 bar plus x3 bar divided by n1 plus n2 plus n3 and so on. Then next, compute the difference between the means of various samples and the grand mean. That is equal to x1 bar minus grand mean, comma x2 bar minus grand mean, etc. Square these deviations and sum it. This will give the sum of squares between the sample. Then next, divide the total obtained in fourth column by degrees of freedom c minus 1 among the samples. This will give the mean of the sum of the squares of deviations between mean of the columns and the grand mean designated as MSE. This is called the variance between the sample. This indicates the degree of explained variance due to sampling deviations. Let us discuss computations of variance within the sample. It is the sum of the squares of variation between the individual items and the sample mean and is denoted by SSE. It measures the inter-sample difference due to chance only. It also measures the variability around them of each group. Since the variability is not attached by group difference, it can be considered a measure of the random variation of values within a group. The steps in calculating variance within the samples will be: first, compute the mean of each samples, that is x1 bar, x2 bar, x3 bar, etc. Then compute the deviations of the various items in a sample from the mean values of the respective samples, that is x1 bar minus grand mean, x2 bar minus grand mean, x3 bar grand mean, etc. Then square these deviations and obtain the total, which gives the sum of squares within the samples. Divide the total in third steps by degrees of freedom v is equal to n minus c, where c refers to the number of samples and n refers to the total number of all the observations. Computations of total sum of squares of variations. That is equal to the total sum of squares refers to total of SSE and SSE. It is the sum square of deviations between the individual items and the grand mean. This, when divided by degrees of freedom n minus 1, gives the total variation comprising both the explained and the unexplained variance. This is the analysis of variance table. The first column shows the source of variation and the second column shows the sum of squares and third one is degrees of freedom and fourth column indicates mean sum of squares and then F value. SST is equal to total sum of squares of variances. SSE is equal to sum of squares between samples. SSE is equal to sum of squares within the samples. MSE is equal to mean square between samples. MSE is equal to mean square within the sample. The same steps for analysis of variance is applicable for both the equal and unequal sample sizes. Computation of F ratio. The F value is the ratio of unexplained variance MSE and explained variance MSE and is derived by taking the ratio of higher over the lower ones of two variants MSE or MSE. Then decision. Compare the computed value of F with the critical value of F for C-1, N-C, degrees of freedom at specific level of significance, generally 5% or 1%, and use the following for reaching to a conclusion. First one, if calculated value of F is greater than the tabulated value, the difference is significant and reject the null hypothesis or accept the alternate hypothesis. Second one, if the calculated value is less than table value, the difference is insignificant and accept the null hypothesis and reject the alternate hypothesis. The difference have arisen due to fluctuations of sampling. Rationale of F ratio test. We know that the variation between the sample means reflect not only the effect of same chance forces which has affected the variation within the sample, but also the effect of forces, if any, which cause the various sample means to differ from another. Thus, if there is any such force, that is, if the hypothesis stands false or not true, the variation between the sample mean will tend to be larger than the variation within the samples. This precisely what the test is designated to identify. Example: the following table gives the yields on 15 sample plots under 3 varieties of seeds. We have to find out if the average yields of land under different varieties of seed show significant difference. Solution: here we shall apply F ratio test. Form a null hypothesis, that is H0. The average yields of land under different varieties of seed do not show significant differences. Alternate hypothesis H1: the average yields of land under different varieties of seed do show a significant difference. Test statistics. Under H0, the test statistics F is equal to variance between the samples divided by variance within the samples. Computation of variance between and variance within the varieties are shown below. From the above table, we have sum of the squares of deviations within the samples or varieties equal to 140. Sum of squares of deviation between the varieties is equal to 35 into 5 is equal to 190. Then degrees of freedom is equal to C into N minus 1 is equal to 3 into 5 minus 1 is equal to 3 into 4 is equal to 12. Degrees of freedom between the varieties is equal to C minus 1 is equal to 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. With the help of the above data, the table of the analysis of variance is constructed as follows. Then decision. The calculated value of F is greater than the table value of F at 5% level of significance. Hence, the difference in the mean values of the varieties is significant and we reject the null hypothesis. We conclude therefore that the average yields of land and the different varieties of seed show significant difference. Let us consider yet another example to test the significance of the variation of the retail prices of commodity in three principal cities, Bombay, Calcutta and Delhi. Four shops were chosen at random in each city and prices observed in rupees were as follows. Do the data indicate that the prices in the three cities are significantly different? Solution. Since it is one-way classification data, we can test it by F-ratio test. First one, null hypothesis, H0, prices in the three cities are not different. Alternate hypothesis, prices in the three cities are different. Test statistics, under H0, the test statistics is F is equal to variance between the samples divided by variance within the sample. The computation of mean X and grand mean X bar is as follows. Grand mean is equal to X1 bar plus X2 bar plus X3 bar by 3. So that is equal to 12.5 plus 10 plus 7.5 by 3 is equal to 10. Then computation of variance between samples, that is given in the following table. Then computation of variance within the samples, that is also given in the table. Then based on the above tables, we can construct the ANOVA table. The first column shows the source of variation. The second column shows the sum of squares. And then third column shows the degrees of freedom. And then fourth column shows the mean sum of squares. And then last column shows the F value. Then next decision. Since the calculated value is less than the table value of F, at 5% level of significance for 2 and 9 degrees of freedom, the difference is not significant. Hence, accept the null hypothesis. We conclude therefore that the prices in the three cities are not significantly different. Then let us discuss shortcut method. The above method of calculating the sum of square of variance between samples and variance within the sample is not generally followed in practice as it is time consuming. An easier method known as shortcut method is usually followed. The procedure of ANOVA under shortcut method is as follows. Firstly, total of sample items, that is sigma x1, sigma x2, etc. and sum of squares of items, that is sigma x1 squared, sigma x2 squared, etc. are calculated. Correction factor after the above. A correction factor is obtained in following manner. Correction factor is equal to t squared by n, where t squared is equal to sigma x1 plus sigma x2 plus sigma x3 the whole square divided by n. N is equal to number of sample items. Then next one, total sum of square is calculated. It is obtained by subtracting the correction factor from the sum of squares of sample. That is, total sum of square is equal to sigma x1 squared plus sigma x2 squared minus t squared by n. Between sample sum of square is calculated as follows. This can be obtained by subtracting the correction factor from the sum of squares of samples divided by respective numbers. That is equal to sigma x1 the whole square plus sigma x2 the whole square divided by n1 plus n2 minus t squared by n. Within samples, sum of square is calculated as follows. This can be obtained by subtracting between sample sum of square from total sum of square. That is, within sample sum of square is equal to total sum of square minus between sample sum of square, or SSR is equal to SST minus SSC. Then ANOVA table and interpretation. The analysis of variance table, calculation of F ratio and its interpretation is done like direct method. The following example will clear the calculation of ANOVA based on shortcut method. In the above sample, the total sum of all items T is equal to sigma x1 plus sigma x2 plus sigma x3 is equal to 50 plus 40 plus 30 is equal to 120. Correction factor is equal to T squared by N equal to 120 the whole squared by 12 equal to 14,400 by 12 is equal to 1,200. SST is equal to sigma x1 squared plus sigma x2 squared minus T squared by N. That is equal to 1040 plus 432 plus 244 minus 1200 equal to 1716 minus 1200 equal to 516. SSC is equal to sigma x1 the whole squared by n1 plus sigma x2 the whole squared by n2 minus t squared by n. That is equal to 50 the whole squared by 4 plus 40 the whole squared by 4 plus 30 the whole squared by 4 minus 1200 equal to 5000 by 4 minus 1200 equal to 1250 minus 1200 equal to 50. Therefore, SSC equal to SST minus SSC equal to 416 minus 50 is equal to 466. The remaining procedure is same as in the direct method. Let us summarize. The analysis of variance is used to compare the mean of more than two groups. The value of F is calculated as F is equal to sample sum of squares between sample divided by sample sum of squares within the samples. The sample sum of squares between samples indicates the explained variation. The sample sum of squares within the sample indicates the unexplained variation. In the above modules, we discussed both direct method and shortcut method. The shortcut method is easier than the direct method. Based on the above procedure, try to practice more application-oriented problems which will give you more understanding. Thank you.